two things that I'm really reflecting on. The first is power. And particularly as you think about organizing women's power, it took 100 years for these women to get to the point that they did in order for the 19th Amendment to pass. And so I don't want that to be lost, how long it actually took to get to this milestone. And then the other thing is, in throughout the course of the struggle to get suffrage, these women were really focused on that we're not building power for ourselves. What we're trying to do is create a world where we can elect better men. And whether that was a strategy or the actual truth, it's been a prophecy, right? So part of the concern is that when women got the right to vote, that they were gonna take everything over and then men were gonna lose power. And women continued to assure men that that wouldn't be the case. In fact, a lot of women walked away from it entirely, saying that they didn't think that women should be able to vote. And I think that that deference still sits with us. So I think about 100 years later and what is being built with supermajority, how we're really focusing on the fact that we are women, the majority of the population, and we're not yielding our power for the electoral results that we need. So that's the first thing. And then the second thing that I've just been thinking about generally is the truth. This country is finally reckoning with the truth of our history. And in order for us to build anything new, we have to excavate the old. And all of the 19th Amendment arguments, and I'm sure we'll get into this later, really kind of erase the role that Black women played in this role. And Martha Jones just has a book that's about to come out called Vanguard, where she's really unearthing exactly this and telling the story that how Black women fought for the right to vote with the 15th Amendment, which gave Black people the right to vote, Black men the right to vote, and then continued for 50 years more to give women and Black women the right to vote. And we'll get into how the splits and all that happened as a result of that, but those are the two things that I'm holding, is how do we yield our power and our numbers and actually lean into that instead of trying to put it away to make men comfortable? And secondly, how do we build a new movement that's multiracial and really entrenched in our truth so that we don't repeat the mistakes of the past that really did split feminism in the early stages of enfranchisement?